Hi, this is Professor Bustilli Booth, and this is a video on how to peer review in Canvas. For this particular demonstration, I will use Business 101. And if you are in a different class of mine, the instructions will be basically the same. So the first thing you'll want to do is find the assignment. It may appear at your home page, or you can go to modules and then look for the assignment. In this case, it will be in week 5, and you'll click on the assignment for it to appear. And then you will notice on the right-hand column that there are, you know, you've been assigned some peer reviews. In this case, I've set up the setting for anonymous and for you to have 3 peers to review. And so once you click, and you'll need to click each one in order to do the reviews, you know, in turn, and you will also see your own submission, but you will not obviously be reviewing your own. So you'll click those peer reviews. It may appear slightly different on your pane because it's the instructional view for me. But at any rate, you can possibly, you know, download the document so that you can view it. Or if you click it, it should appear on the left hand pane over here. And then you'll want to click the view rubric. It, your view rubric icon may be on the upper right hand corner. Just look for it. And then you'll click that and the rubric will appear. Okay. And here are the different criteria against which you will be reviewing the assignment itself. And you will assign points according to your perspective of how well your peer met the criteria. All right. So for example, in this case, I'll find a 3-point and then the number will appear here. And then maybe I'll assign a 2-point for product, service, and description, and then a number of other points for each of these criteria. And the system automatically adds that for you, in this case, 12 out of 15. And so once you save that, that number will appear as a total up here, and the rubric will disappear. Now, you may also notice here this green callout box. And if you were to click that, you'll be able to, you know, enter your additional comments for that area. And I highly recommend that you give very specific feedback, not just good job, but how, as a reader, for example, you know, you were able to gain some insight from what was written there, or any kind of curiosity or question that you might have to help your peer think further about the assignment. That's really the more important thing to do there. And then you'll want to update your comments and it will record it in here. You won't see it once you, I mean, you can go back and see it, but once you've saved it, you know, it minimizes so it's no longer for you to view, but it is there. And then, you know, you'll save the whole thing, right? And all the points will show up at the upper corner, at the total box. And then if you want to do additional comments, you can go ahead and put them here in this box and then submit, and then you're done. And then you go back to doing the next assignment so that you can complete the portion for the peer reviews that is your own. All right. And if you are wondering what points assignments are associated with your own peer review activity, be sure to read the instructions. I hope that helps. And if it does not, please be sure to email me so I can clarify it for you. Thanks so much.